Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I
get
walked. I don't want to say any excuses. Oh, we had Hollywood.
They had all people.
Nah, it was just the ego. Better suck in my gut.
Yeah, of course.
A bit more.
Mike always has on our whiteboard what we're going to do for the day, and he'll explain it, and then if you're up for it, you do it. And if you, for anyone that's injured or sick, they just scale it back to something that they can handle. So we'll see what Mike's got in store for us this morning.
I'm still here. Geese are still here.
Well, let's stop talking something. And let's get going.
Okay, let's see what we got.
Terry never will say that, but he's on camera, and he's probably going to contact you, Jordan, to get his fee that he he wants. He's never like this. He's typically an asshole all the time.
But, I was never an asshole until I met one.
All right, let's explain the workout, what we got today.
After CrossFit came into vogue and I retired, then that's when the geezers really started taking off with that age group that I have on the back of my shirt. That's when it truly took off in that, you know, in that aspect of it. And that was just, it's just fitness. No one can do the snatch and clean and jerk because their joints hurt and they're tight and immobile and, you know, those sort of things. But I mean, a couple of us still do snatches with the bar, or, you know, hang cleans and presses and that sort of thing, but I don't do any of that stuff just because it hurts so much.
This group of guys is just incredible. No egos. It's the easiest group to get along with. I enjoy greeting everybody, and at the end of the workout, I enjoy saying, hey, see you next workout.
Yeah, McFadden's got the ego. He's the guy that's got the biggest ego here. He's got the biggest stomach. Well, maybe not.
Bernie, we got to team up now.
Without saying name now.
When I first saw Adrian, he was coming up over that little hill, and I thought it was a woman. I swear, because of the nice little ponytail. And, but then the more he worked out here, the more he started to turn into a man. Now look at him.
Now, we give each other crap all the time, and we're really hard on each other. But at the same time, if somebody needs something, we'll be right there for them. Or if somebody doesn't show up, we'll text and call them. But the togetherness and the camaraderie of the group is what, you know, really drives us, just like the Marine Corps. So it was a natural fit for me to have a great gym for people to come to. And I mean, we take care of each other. My first association with Glassman and what he wanted to accomplish, and the camaraderie and the togetherness and the spirit of fitness, that's what happened here.
This is my lifeblood to continue growing and being healthy, because I have Parkinson's and it kicks my ass on a regular basis, except when I come up here and I get through it and I'm feeling better. And it's a panacea for everything as far as I'm concerned. And
we don't cut him any slack because he's got Parkinson's. I mean, it's one of those things.
Excuses.
I mean, yeah. he comes up here and we just say, man up, Fast Eddie.
He doesn't want any slack.
And he doesn't.
I mean, you've got to chase after him.
The beauty of that is understanding that if anything happens to him, like George was saying, we'd be there at the drop of a hat.
Yeah.
We're very caring. But guys, we're different than the ladies. You know, the ladies are, you know, they'll go, oh, good job, you know. But I'll call Terry a fat butt or a fat ass or whatever. But it's all in love. And that's the important thing to remember, that as we get older, that we really stay together and we have a great time doing it. You know, so
we're older, but we can get up off the mat, you know, and like when we get home, you know, I'm able to play with my grandson and get on the floor with him and be able to stand up. And, you know, I'm just so grateful, you know, because I have seen other guys that I used to know that's our age, and they're look emaciated, you know, they don't look healthy.
Well, you guys, this is all very touching.
He's a newbie.
I'm the probie here. Okay, shut up now. It's my turn.
Ooh, he's a geezer.
He's a geezer. Right, welcome to the group.
And I frankly thought I was signing up for, you know, a fitness program. I've had a desk job for 35 years and sitting on my butt all day long. I'm obviously out of shape. So that was my motivation. But as you guys are pointing out, it's much more than that. I appreciate all of it, and I look forward to the community. The community.
Fresh meat.
I now understand the difference between pain through workout and pain through pain because you didn't do something that you're supposed to do. So not only have I learned the camaraderie, like I said, I call it the miracle on the hill. And for me, it has been a godsend. You guys are the most important thing to me at this point in time in my life.
It's just as much a social club as it is a workout. We were just talking about that last night at the game. That,
an obnoxious social club.
Yeah, and it's, you know, it's something, someplace where you can speak your mind, you can goof around, you can be an idiot, or you can be the smartest guy in the room. It doesn't matter. Everybody's accepting, and it's a great group. And in our private lives, I think everybody has helped each other too. You know, it's an inspiration to look up to guys that are 10 or 20 years older than I am, and I want to be that guy. I want to be able to do that when I'm 20 years older than I am right now.
Socializing for men is as important in their later lives as the weightlifting and the longevity. And so there's some studies that actually say it's more important. This is Mike's give back. There's no charge for any of this that goes on.
Yeah.
And this is one of the many give backs Mike gives back, because he feels his life's been so blessed in what he's been able to do. So he is out actually spreading that blessing. So he's giving that back, and nobody's charged coming up here.
The most important thing is to get here. You know, we even encourage guys, even if you're sick, come. You know, if you're hurt, come. You know, I came here not expecting to do anything one time, and I did a workout. When I left, I go, well, that was a lot more than I thought I was going to do. So here we go.
Get yourself loosened up, guys, and we'll start it in less than 5 minutes. All right.
This lifestyle is important for us at a later life to be able to enjoy and get out and do things. You know, I met a guy at the grocery store today that was in the Marine Corps the same time I was, and I swore I thought he was 80 years old. And he's my age. And, I don't want that. I want to be able, none of us get out of here alive. So I want to know that in the later years of my life, like now, that I can go walk 4 or 5 miles on the beach, and I can work out 3 days a week, and hopefully that the younger generation will look at me and try to, you know, I want to be like Coach B when I'm older. And that's the old Marine Corps thing. It's like lead by example, and that's what we try to do. And not just me, but all of us try to do is lead by example, so that people that see us will want to be part of what we have.
Finish strong, guys. Almost there.
Why do they call you Fast Eddie?
When I was in college, the professor would ask a question, and I usually would be the first to blurt out four or five answers to the question. And so they said, "You're too fast, go away." So that's where I started.
What happened?
Well, I was in the greatest shape. Would you shut up so I can talk? Jeez, this guy, he intimidated. Anyway, I got hit in the head with a baseball. Right here, two hematomas on the brain. You can't tell by now, but it's not round. It's cone shape. I never should have said that.
But, are we talking about your head?
It collapsed.
I
can't freaking win.
Well, that's the idea, is to live as long as you can with the quality of life that's going to be able to enjoy it. So,
absolutely.
And I encourage everybody that's out there that, as Terry said, that's watching this, is that if you are a geezer with showing your shirt, Fast Eddie, remember that geezers rule. And we're all patriots, and this is Mike's gym in Bonsall, California. And if you're ever in the area, you're always welcome to come up here and train with us. You know, so.